November 27th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, Revelation chapter 16 from the New Testament. Then I heard a loud voice from the temple declaring to the seven angels, "Go and pour out on the earth the seven bowls containing God's wrath." So the first angel went and poured out his bowl on the earth. Then ugly and painful sores appeared on the people who had the mark of the beast and who worshipped his image. Next, the second angel poured out his bowl on the sea, and it turned into blood, like that of a corpse, and every living creature that was in the sea died. Then the third angel poured out his bowl on the rivers and the springs of water, and they turned into blood. Now I heard the angel of the waters saying, "You are just, the one who is and who was, the Holy One, because you have passed these judgments. Because they poured out the blood of your saints and prophets, so you have given them blood to drink. They got what they deserved." Then I heard the altar reply, "Yes, Lord God, the all-powerful, your judgments are true and just." Then the fourth angel poured out his bowl on the sun, and it was permitted to scorch people with fire. Thus people were scorched by the terrible heat. Yet they blaspheme the name of God who has ruling authority over these plagues, and they would not repent and give him glory. Then the fifth angel poured out his bowl on the throne of the beast, so that darkness covered his kingdom, and people began to bite their tongues because of their pain. They blaspheme the God of heaven because of their sufferings and because of their sores, but nevertheless, they still refuse to repent of their deeds. Then the sixth angel poured out his bowl on the great river Euphrates and dried up its water to prepare the way for the kings from the east. Then I saw three unclean spirits that looked like frogs coming out of the mouth of the dragon, out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet. For they are the spirits of the demons performing signs who go out to the kings of the earth to bring them together for the battle that will take place on the great day of God, the all-powerful. Look, I will come like a thief. Blessed is the one who stays alert and does not lose his clothes, so that he will not have to walk around naked and his shameful condition be seen. Now the spirits gathered the kings and their armies to the place that is called Armageddon in Hebrew. Finally, the seventh angel poured out his bowl into the air, and a loud voice came out of the temple from the throne saying, "It is done." Then there were flashes of lightning, roaring, and crashes of thunder, and there was a tremendous earthquake, an earthquake unequaled since humanity has been on the earth. So tremendous was that earthquake. The great city was split into three parts, and the cities of the nations collapsed. So Babylon the Great was remembered before God, and was given the cup filled with the wine made of God's furious wrath. Every island fled away, and no mountains could be found. And gigantic hailstones, weighing about 100 pounds each, fell from heaven on people. But they blasphemed God because of the plague of hail, since it was so horrendous. God, in this chapter of Revelation, as we get ready for the new earth and new heaven, which is so exciting, we receive the third blessing in Revelation. That talks about being prepared, being alert. And I think all of Revelation, well, the whole Bible, but especially Revelation, speaks to us being alert, being ready. We don't know when the end of times will happen. We don't know if it will be right now, as I'm recording this, or in thousands and thousands of years. Only you know that. But we need to be alert, not because we can lose our salvation, but being alert for people around us. You know, I noticed, especially in the last couple days, you've just been speaking volumes into my life about how sometimes my life goes along unintentionally. I go through, it's sort of like when you drive a car and you get to some place and you don't remember actually driving there. Especially lately, with as crazy as my life is this month and next month, I seem to be on autopilot. It doesn't mean that I've turned into a mean, evil person, but I'm not intentionally seeking out your plans for me. I'm not intentionally seeking out your path. I think I'm doing good. I think I'm doing right. You know, I read my Bible. I talk to you. But it almost seems to be on autopilot. And this blessing says, blessed is the one who stays alert. And I don't think we're alert enough. I think we go through life on autopilot way too much. At least I do. So I love that blessing you've given me of a reminder of being alert, of being intentional in everything around me, being intentional of other people and other feelings, being intentional of my choices in life, being intentional of my thoughts and what I'm allowing myself to think, being intentional about what I'm reading and seeing and participating in and how that's affecting my life. The other two blessings were talking about reading your word and keeping your word, and that those who die as people, as your children, will receive their rest. But this third blessing is a true blessing in my life. Be alert. Don't go through life just unintentionally. And what I find fascinating is there's no unintentionality in this great big huge unseen fight that's happening even right now. I mean, in this world, we haven't got to Armageddon yet, but the fight that's going on right now is very intentional. Everybody's on their guard in the unseen world. Angels and demons and fighting for us and against us. Especially here in the United States, we're not used to that. We're not used to being on alert because we're not in war. But I have friends who are in the middle of war-torn countries, and they're constantly alert, constantly aware of sounds, constantly aware of people around them. And so the world unseen is alert. We are not. God, I want to be intentional in everything I do for you, glorifying you, with you, because of you. Nothing in my life that you've given me has been unintentional. You never turn off in my life. You're just constantly there for me, constantly doing things for me, constantly watching out for me, guiding me, teaching me. I want my response, my worship to you, to be intentional as well. God, we know that the last plague on Egypt before Pharaoh finally let your people go was darkness. We know that the bowl that was thrown on the throne of Satan was darkness. God, you bring light to my life. And where your light shines, there's no chance of any darkness in my life to be there. And I want that to be intentional. And I want my walk today to be intentional. God, for everyone listening today, allow their worship to you to be intentional. Allow them to be alert to everything going on around them. We may not be able to see the unseen battle that is happening, but at the very least, we should be intentionally aware of that. God, allow us to be intentionally aware of the blessings you give us. Allow us to be intentionally aware of our actions and what our lives look like to other people. God, I thank you for your intentional love for me, who so doesn't deserve that overwhelming attention that you give me, who I cower underneath all of that attention in a silly way, thinking I can hide from you, just like Adam and Eve did way back when in the garden. God, I do thank you for your intentional love and the love of your Son who died for me. I pray all this in his name. Amen. We'll be right back.